Well, fine. Good evening, everyone. This is Patricia, and I am traveling for history. I'm in Burlington, Vermont today, and this is Burlington High School, BHS. I already have a video on this on my channel, which I'll put a link in below in the video. I want to do a walk around of the exterior because I don't think my high school is going to be around much longer. There are 5 plans that have been presented now to everyone. They range in price from $181 million to $199 million to replace this school, because my high school is contaminated with PCBs, polychlorinated biphenyls. Cancer-causing agents, that's all you really need to know what that stands for. Nothing good, that's for sure. What I can say about these halls is in the wintertime, we're talking doggone cold. Very chilly. When I was a student here, electric heat was used. There are no heaters in the halls. And as you can see, they are glass. Maybe they're plexiglass now, but they were certain glass when I was a student here. We can see from the cornerstone that it was built in 63. I think the first graduating class, though, was 1965. So, if memory serves me correctly, well, this is definitely a building. A building has, at least when I was here, the cafeteria, auditorium, gymnasium, what else? Principal's office. When I was a student here, there was a switchboard operator. She had an office as well. Pearl Maliski. I think that's her pronunciation of her last name. I found her grave at the Fort Ethan Allen Cemetery in Colchester. That was very unexpected. Let me see. What else? I think the band room was in A building too. I wasn't in band, but in drama club, I had tried out for God knows which musical. I was stage crew, but I did try out for this one show and actually was singing in front of other people. What was I smoking? I don't know. But the teacher, I can't remember his name. Well, for those who also graduated in the 1980s, the early 1980s, you probably know who I'm talking about. I just can't remember his name. But he told me to keep going. My God, I didn't break any windows, that's for sure. Didn't break anyone's eardrums either. Anyway, so if memory serves me correctly, this is B building right here. And I'm pretty sure this is C building. Oh, yes, I see some numbers in the windows up there. So let's see if I can zoom in for you. I can zoom in, but I don't think enough. Oh, maybe. You see right there? Where's my pointer? Right here. It says C106, 105, 10 something. Alrighty. So let's walk up the stairs, which admittedly, I didn't walk around outside. Here's a sculpture that, I don't know what that is, a sculpture of. And I know from last time there's nothing on there to tell us either. God, that's annoying. So, but they're going to be tearing down my high school pretty soon. By the way, I've been trying to film the interior of this, take photos of it before they do that. But my gosh, it's beyond trying to pull teeth around here. So if you know anybody who knows anybody who can get me in the building with a master key, let's talk, shall we? My gosh, the school district has been challenging, shall we say. Ooh, daffodils? I think so. I know they're an early bloomer, shall we say. Now, I will say, since you know I use a cane, climbing the stairs can be a bit difficult when I'm carrying my camera. But I'll do my best. Today I'm not seeming to have an issue walking up the stairs, which is good. And I'm not huffing and puffing, which is even better. Yep. Now I'm not going to try to get in, because that would be, oh yeah, here we go. Outside of the building. It gives us the letter B. Yay. Wonder how long the bee's been up there. But then again, I only use the interior to get from point A to point B. Now, B building, I'll just keep using the present tense until I hear otherwise. But B building has the library. So up the hallway here, up the steps, directly on the left, library. And what is this? I don't know whose office this was. I don't know what kind of office it was. Oh! I bet you this was the assistant principal's office. Because, let me see. Could that be? Gosh, it's been so long. I mean, we're talking next year, 2023, will be my 40th high school reunion. 40th! Can you imagine? There are days when it feels like it was just yesterday. And there are other times when I'm thinking, it hasn't been 80 years already? Oh, my goodness gracious. Looky up here. I kind of doubt it was paved when I was in high school. Could be wrong about that. Oh, they've already got it, this particle board, because they're going to tear it down, of course. I think I've already said that a few times. It does break my heart. First time I heard that, I had tears in my eyes. Another cold hallway. Very cold hallway. The lights are on. Huh. Maybe that's to discourage people from trying to get into the building. Whew. It's all uphill from here. I'd really like to film this before they tear it down. It's the one thing so many of us talk about is how there are no photographs. Or let's face it, over the course of, well, since 63, almost, was it 59 years? Over the course of 59 years, there'll be some photographs, certainly. The yearbook would have some, and a variety of staff and teachers and students would have taken photographs as well, but if you've been watching my videos for a while, particularly those of the cemeteries, you know I take a plethora of photographs. And that's a good thing. But it may be too late. And I have to say that breaks my heart more than you can imagine. So this is C building. And when I was a student, C building, first of all, there was smoking allowed on campus, but only in designated areas. So C building, the lower portion here, was open to smoking. Now, I remember in the wintertime that the students who smoked, that was not me, would stand outside the doors and leave the doors ajar so they had some heat, which also meant that those of us who didn't like the smell of smoke were inundated with a wall of it. It was disgusting. Restricted area, do not enter, authorized personnel only. I'm guessing teachers and staff. C203, right here. I wish I had smell-o-vision for you. The smell of spring grass. Oh, I love that smell. Parking light's on too. Can you tell? It is on. It has an orangish glow to it. E buildings right here. There are 6 buildings, A, B, D, A, B, C, D, E, and F building. This is E building. Let me see if I can remember correctly. B was art and languages. C, history and English. E, science and math. And F had the courses one would take, vocational courses, car mechanics, child care, culinary. What did D have? Business? Was D building typing and business courses? I want to say so. Oh, it's been so long. It's a drug-free zone. I don't know if the buildings were used in the same way since I was here. I'm just talking about when I was here. So we can see LIB, library. I loved going to the library. Now, when I was in school, this was long before personal computers. Oh, so long before personal computers. And it was really all about reading, studying, all that kind of stuff. No cell phones either. Long before that as well. Definitely looks like a greenhouse. I don't recall this being here when I was here. You can see this is E building. I'd be interested in knowing. Well, it is 3 stories. 304 up there. Because most of the buildings are 2-story shoeboxes. But when I was a student here, I was on the school newspaper, the Burlington Register, BHS Register, and I sold more newspapers than anyone else, so I became circulation manager, 10 cents a copy. Teachers were an easy mark, I have to say. very supportive, very, very supportive of the school paper. I want to say the newspaper came out weekly. We have D building right here. So much of this doggone graffiti. I'd like to take these spray cans and shove them where the sun don't shine on these people. It makes me so angry. This door is locked. Please go to the main entrance. I mean, look at this pile here. As much as I would love to, I can see, and so can you. That is a hallway right there. So, restricted visitors, sick people with coughs, sore throats, aches, fevers, or other respiratory illness symptoms are restricted from entering this building. Healthy visitors, clean your hands before and after visiting this location or after coughing or sneezing. Masks are required to be worn while in the building. Please limit number of visitors and length of visit. Thank you for helping to protect the health and safety of our staff and students. These are temporary visitor restrictions. And in case you can't read that sign, let me zoom in so you can. I'm not actually going to walk through this pile of leaves. I had a tick come home with me last year, and I'm not in the mood to deal with that again. But anyway, and we see this light is also on. It is a bit dark in this corner. I can see why. All right. Let's continue to walk up. As soon as I finish taking photographs, of course. We may never get another chance. I may never get another chance. I dare say, I think my voice is going to break. Interesting bits of stones. They remind me a bit of rubble. Well, there's nothing coming off the building. We can see that. I like the perspective of this shot. You want to look at my photos? I'd love for you to look at my photos. Instagram, traveling for history. 1L, of course, in traveling. Facebook, traveling for history. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me there too. Traveling for HI with the number 1. Traveling for high 1. Huh. Well, I'm already here, so these must be for drainage. That makes sense, that this is for drainage. Oh yeah, and here we have what appears to be a drainage pipe, right here. Ooh, wonder if that's a handrail sort of hole, but who knows. I don't think I can get a picture of that. Well, there we go. Yes, I can. And me. And you see all the lights run in there too. Oops. Yeah, all those lockers. I do wonder, though, I mean, it's been nearly 40 years. Anybody else take Latin with Lainey or her American Lit class? Remember how her room was just painted with all these Roman, silly Roman figures? I do. It was pretty, pretty insane, quite frankly. But, this is gonna be slick, isn't it? Not too bad. Wonder what's back here. So I just wonder if there's anything left from that if they painted over it all. I mean, it would make sense to paint over it all. But, I've never been all the way up here before. Wonder what that building is. Doesn't look like storage. And what's in here? The stairs. Come on, back into focus. Come on, focus. That's gonna be an awful photograph. Interesting now. What can my eyes see? Oh yeah, definitely stairs. Stickers that says suicide prevention. Interesting. Another hole. Kind of interesting. I mean, maybe they're just mouse holes. Wonder. It is the same color brick as the high school itself. This is still E building. G? I'm not aware of a G building. But they have a playground over here. I mean, as I said, they did have a class for learning how to take care of children, like daycare sort of classes. Air filters at the wazoo. I like the juxtaposition where you can look inside and still see the high school behind us. Of course, she can see me as well. And heaters. Really gonna have to ride them about coming over and filming the inside. I told them I would sign a stack of waiver forms. And if I develop cancer or some other illness, oh well, sucks to be me. But, so frustrating. I don't know if I can capture the inside here. No, probably not. It doesn't look good. Oh, there we go. There we go. Pretty neat. But I don't know what this building is. Besides storage and some sort of, what's the word I'm looking for? Maintenance sort of building? Probably. School grounds are tobacco free. State law prohibits the use of tobacco and tobacco substitutes on all school property, everywhere, by everyone, at all times. My best guess is you can't smoke in your car either. But like the hospital, right? In case you don't know, you can't smoke on the grounds of the hospital, not even sitting in your own car if you're parked on their property. All right, well, I'm going to continue to explore, but I have to, that will have to be in part two of this video. So, thank you so much for watching. If you're enjoying the content, hey, please subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it. 164 people and growing. There's always room for more, folks. Always, always room for more. So please subscribe. I upload every day of the week as of April 24, 2022. So, hey, come on down. This is Patricia, and I am traveling for history. Personal history. Until I see you again, have a great night. Thanks for watching.